Now just open the board to a full screen mode. Just go to the preference setting and just make it auto pan layout. Now go to the design and layer stack manager. So as you can see here, this is a two layer board. Now I'm just going to add another layer. Just select the top layer, go add another layer, the signal layer one, and add another layer, the signal layer two. Now I'm just going to rename those layers. Just to make the top layer capital L1, the next layer capital L2, the third one is L3, and the last one will be L4. Perfect. Now press OK. So as you can see here, now we can lay out our board with these four layers. So I'm here, we're going to use the four layer because of making it simple. Just go to the some rule setting. Just go to the width here. So here just make some changes with the width design rule. So here I'm just going to use the width will be 0.15, the minimum width. And the preferred will be preferred width will be also 0.15, and the maximum width 0.15. Perfect. So you can use any number here. So I'm just going to use 0.5. Apply. Okay. That's it. Now the next step will be just placing the design rule over the schematic. Just go back to the schematic page, and as you can see here, I'm just going to place a design rule over the schematic so that it will automatically go with that width of the routing. Just go to the place directive parameter rule and place it over the ground, and double click, go to the property section, go to the rule section, go to the add width constraint, double click here. Here we need to change the minimum width for the power ground, which is 0.3 mm. Okay, double click over the constraint. We need to change it to 0.3 mm. So I accidentally just close it down. Just change the preferred width 0.3 mm, and the maximum width 0.3 mm. Okay, perfect. That's it. Just control C, control V, and place that parameter set for the 5 volt also. And we need to place that parameter set for the 3.3 volt. That's it. So just place it place it with any connection. So it will automatically, apply for each and every net. Either it is on page one or page two. Okay. So if you need to just place it once. Okay. That I want to say. Perfect. So we have placed the different width rule for plus 3v3, plus 5 and ground. Just save the schematic. Now just go back to the PCB doc file. Here we need to update some changes. So design, import changes. Just uncheck the rooms, validate, execute changes, close. Perfect. Now we can go for the routing. So just select the top layer first. So I'm just going to start the routing from this upper segment of the board. So by pressing the control and left key and select any pad, and by square bracket, you can easily visualize, you can differentiate any of the pad by its brightness. So you can use control and left key. Now just start routing. So I'm going to route this connection first, the 6-pin ICSP connector with the diode D1. Perfect. Now we can connect this the first pin of the regulator IC. So it is also connected through diode. Perfect. Now we can go for the another connection. So this pin is okay, that is connected here. So I'm just going to connect this pin it is state connection. To make this connection with the 18 pin connector, so for that just zoom a little bit. Okay, so here I'm going to connect the second pin of the J2 connector with the ICSP connection. Yeah, this route will be fine. So just follow the same route that I am doing, okay? Perfect. So by pressing the left key or right key, by pressing the left key, you can simply make the connection, and by right key click, you can move to the previous menu. Okay, so the third pin is connected here. The first pin is connected like this. Okay, so I'm just going to make this connection first. Just select the bottom layer from the layer set and make this connection. Perfect. Now this pin is connected here. Okay. So here I'm going to change. So firstly, what I'll do for via, just place a via anywhere at corner of the PCB. I'm just going to change the property of the via. So its diameter will be 0.4 mm. So it is basically its outer diameter, and now the hole size will be 0.2 mm. Enter. Perfect. So this is the via that we're going to place. So as you can see here, it shows that VI has some error. So before further placement, I'm going to change some property of the via. Okay, just place a wire here first. Okay, just save it. Control C, Control V. So as you can see here, it is showing some error, the constraint error. So just go to the design rules. Just go to the routing vias, and here you need to change the wire diameter and the hole size. So here I'm just going to place the 0.4 mm, the minimum. The maximum should be also 0.4, and the preferred will be also 0.4, maximum 0.2 mm, and preferred will be also 0.2 mm. Apply. Okay. Yeah, as you can see here, the constraint error will be gone. Now I can go for the connection. Perfect. Now the other connection, just make this connect with the ground. Okay. Now we can go for the another connection. Just select the top layer. Control V, place a via, select the bottom layer and make this connection. Just select the top layer, make this connection. Control V, place the via here. So here I'm just not using the top layer, because when we place the top layer also between these two component, then it will basically block the whole path, because the top layer and bottom layer both will be there. Okay. So that's why I'm just changing the layer to the bottom to make this connection. Okay. So you need to think like that. You need to use the minimum layer try to make a connection with a single layer. Okay, then if you find any difficulty with the connection, then you can go for the next layer. Okay, so this is the thought process that I use generally. And by pressing the control and the left click, you can visualize the connection, okay, by different brightness level. And by clicking anywhere else of the board, you can go back to the previous menu. Okay, so I'm just going to connect this like that. So as you can see here, this is basically the advantage of the using the single layer, okay, so that we can cross over the layer easily. Just make this connection first. Okay, perfect. For this connection also, I'm just going to use the bottom layer. Just make this connection like that. Here we go. These are the straightforward connection. So just make it connect first. Perfect. Okay. So to make them connect, we need to place a via here, just control V. So this is basically the advantage of this process. Firstly, just place a via anywhere over the board, just control C that via, just copy that via, and whenever you need it to place a via, just press control V, so it will appear there. Okay, you don't need to click over the, you just go to the menu and select the via again and again. So this is the step that will save lots of your time. By backspace, if you just left click accidentally anywhere over the board during the layout, during the routing, and by backspace, you can go to the previous section. Okay, so these three pins are open, so that's why it is not showing any connection with other pins. Okay, so just I need to make them connect first. So as you can see here, I'm just not using any layer 2 or layer 3. To try to basically, firstly, we need to try to make all the connection with the top and bottom layer. But this is the exact process that I follow for all the layer PCB. If it is either it is 6 layer PCB, 8 layer PCB, anything. Okay. So basically, try to make a routing with the minimum number of layer. Then when you find difficulty, then you can go for the layer change. Just make this connection first. Perfect. Okay, so we need to connect it. So as you can see, why I placed this oscillator like that, because this connection will become very easy. So when you will practice more and more with lots number of components or different layer board, then you will also automatically familiar with like how we can go for component placement, right? It is very useful during the component placement. You need to visualize the layout designing first. I hope you can understand what I want to say. So it is basically the game of experience. So you need to practice more first. Okay. So as you can see here, we can go from this side. Perfect. Just shift a little bit upward. So you need to basically avoid the 90 degree angle between the track. So why we need to avoid this 90 degree angle? Because it will be very difficult for the manufacturer at the time of PCB manufacturing. So it can basically, during the manufacturing, the right angle or 90 degree angle can create the open circuit there, okay? So you need to basically avoid the manufacturing. That's why every manufacturer want that there should be no 90 degree angle between the route. Okay, so make these connections like that. Now okay, so what we can do here, okay, so here we can choose another way, as you can see here. So we need to just delete those wire first, just delete all these connections. So I have thought something to make a better routing. Just delete all those connections that we have made. So basically, for better layout designing, you need to just control Z. Perfect. So be very careful here. You need to just delete the connections only. If accidentally you just delete the any component, then just control Z. Undo those, delete. Okay, so here just I am going to use the bottom layer. Okay, so just select the top layer. Here I am just going to tell you how we can go for these connections. Right click, control V, place via. Just select the via and this particular small connection by using the shift button, control C. Just click over here, control V, and place this connection for all these pins. So this is also a strategy that will follow for complex circuit. So we'll place basically the via next to the pad, so that we can go for the layer change. Okay, control V. Fine. Now here we can go for the bottom layer. As you can see, just make this connection like that. okay, here I forgot something. I need to just extend this wire a little bit upward. Fine. Just change its position also. Fine. Now extend this via connection. Fine. Extend this also. Okay. Okay. Now it is okay. Now we can go for further connection. Like that. This is basically what I want to do. Perfect. Now for this connection, we'll follow the same strategy. Just select the, go to the top layer to make this connection possible. Connect. Fine. Now we can go for another connection. Just make this connect also. Like that. Perfect. So here we have made all the connection with these 8 number of pins. Save. Okay, so now here you can see what is the benefit of that placement. Okay, all the other components just placed near to the connection so that we can easily connect those pins. Okay, so here I think we need to use the layer 2 and layer 3 to make this connection possible as per my experience. Okay, so these three pins are open. Just save this board. Don't forget to save it after each and every connection, because in case if you know by fault, if you made any mistake or something, or the connection will lost. So to make this connection possible, just select the layer 2. So here I think I need to place the via there. Now here we go. So to make them connect, what I can do, just go with this connection first. As you can see here, these pads are connected with each other. So just select the bottom layer and make them connect first. Perfect. Fine. I'm just going to place a via here. Control C, Control V, place a via like that. Okay, so there is a connection bottom the layer 4. So for that, what I can do, I need to shift that via. Okay, so here I'm just going to delete that via, and to make this connection possible, I'm just going to extend this connection first. Perfect. And just control V, place a via here like that. Fine. Now just make the connection. Okay, just press the control Z, because there was also on the top layer, bottom of that layer 4. So here I'm just going to place a via. So before that, make this connection, place a via here. Fine. Now we can change the layer to the top and make this connection. Okay, perfect. Okay, so this pin is connected there. So what we can do, just go to the top layer, make a connection like that, place a via here, control V, fine, change the layer to second layer L2. Just make the connection. Like that. So this is basically the benefit if you didn't use any, you know, multiple layer set unnecessarily. So in case of the complex connection, you can use the other layer set very frequently, okay? Very easily. Perfect. Now just select this pin where it is connected. Okay, just view the fitboard connected with the J2 connector. Okay, so as you can see here, there is a constraint error, so I need to shift the connection a little bit. So I'll just after the layout designing, I'll just resolve those errors, okay, with the better placement of the overlay layer. We can easily resolve those errors. Okay, so before that connection, here you can see I'm just going to use the same strategy, a little wire and a via placement, control C, click over the center of the via, control V, perfect. Just pressing shift and copy this connection, control C, click over the connection. So here I'm going to place a direct connection with the layer 2 like that. As you can see, just select the third one. Okay, so it is just connected with this capacitor. So to make this possible, just firstly go to the fit board view, and to make them connect, I need to place a via because there is a layer change. So just press Control V, place a via. Perfect. Now I'm just going with the layer 2 to make this connection like that. Just make a connection till here. Just place a via. Before that, you need to just copy a via. Control C. Control V. Place a via here. Perfect. Now just shift a little bit. Okay, now it's fine. Change the layer to the bottom layer or layer 4. Just make this connection. Perfect. Now go to the layer next pad. Okay, so this is the ground pad. To make this connection, firstly just connect all these ground together by using the L4 layer. Just press Ctrl V, place our via here. Okay, so there is a connection. So for via placement, yeah, we can place. Okay, so to make this connection possible, just Ctrl C, Ctrl V. Okay, so this is the error because the ground, there we have placed a rule. The ground should be minimum 0.3 mm thick wire. Fine. Here we go. So as you can see, we have made this connection like that. Now go to the next pad. Just select the top layer and make a connection like that. Place a via here. Just copy a via, Control C, click over the center of the via, Control V, perfect. Now change the layer to second layer, the L2. Just make it connection like the previous one. Fine. Just shift it a little bit upward. Okay. Just select the third one. So where it is connected? Okay, so it is connected there. So for that, what we can do? Okay, so okay, so this connection is also there. So to make this connection, just go to the layer one first. And just extend the connection till here. place a via, control V, perfect. Now go with the next pad connection, because it is also connected the next pin of 18 pin connector. Control V, place via, perfect. Now we can go for the connection. Just view a fit board, zoom a little bit. Here we go. Now to make this connection possible, firstly okay, so we need to use the layer 3 here. So I just select layer 3. Okay, fine. Now we can go like that. Just make this connection. Perfect. Now just select the third one. Yeah, you can see. So to make this connection possible, firstly extend the connection little bit, place a via. Now control C, just follow the same strategy. Control V, place it here. Control V, control V, perfect. Okay, so these connections are different, so we'll follow different strategy to make this connection possible. So before that, we need to make this connection first. Just go to the layer 2. Okay, so we need to use the layer 3 to make them connection. Perfect. Fine. So we have made these correction perfectly. Now we can go for the other connection. Just connect it directly like that. Just copy a via. Control C, click over the via. Control V, place it here. Change the layer to the L4 and make them connect. Fine. So we have made this connection perfectly. Okay, so the reset pin is also connected there. Okay, so to make this connection, what we can do? We need to use the layer 3 and just we can go around the connector J2. And the other pin is connected to there. So I'm just going to make this connection first. Just extend the wire a little bit. Place a via here, control V. And go to the layer change, L4. And connect it. Fine. Just save the PCB doc page. Okay, similarly, we need to follow this step also. Just copy a via, and a connection there. Okay, it is not happening. I don't know why. So just don't waste time here. Just to make this connection, just change the layer to L1 and extend the wire a little bit like that. Place a via, control V, change the layer to L4 and just make them connect like that. Perfect. Now go for the another pad. So where it is connected. Okay. So as you can see, it is connected with the J1 connector. Okay. So I have different strategy for to make them these connection, the D1, D4, D3. So just leave this connection as it is. I'm just going with the J2 connector first. So there are few connections which are still remains. Just change the layer set to L2 and just going like that. Perfect. Just place a via here, control V, change the layer L1 and make this connection. Perfect. Okay, so to connect this, just change the layer to L2. Okay, so it is not possible like that. So for that, what we can do? Just shift this a little bit. Perfect. Now just select the layer 3, or we can go with the, if we select layer 2, then we need to place a via here to cross this connection, and after that we need to place. Okay, so we can go with the, if we'll go with layer okay, so I'm just going with the layer 2. Just make this connection a little bit closer. Select the layer 2. Okay. Perfect. Control V, place a via here. Fine. Now we can cross the connection with layer 2. Perfect. So just make a connection with layer 2 here, place a via. Control V, change the layer to bottom. Here I'm going to use the bottom layer, the L4 or L1. L1 will be okay. Perfect. So we have made this connection also. Now the other one. So to make them connect, okay, so these are the continuous connection. So for that we should follow a same strategy, a via and a little trace. Now place via, control V, perfect. Now for this connection, similar. Okay, so there will be okay. Control V. And for the other one, similarly, place a little trace and via. So this is very important strategy that we'll follow for complex connection. So just place, I call it generally a trace and via strategy. So from that, we can simply make all the connections. So there will be very easy for, you know, if we go with the layer change. Now just go with the layer 2 to make this connection possible. Perfect. And to make it connect, I'm going like that. Fine. As you can see, like how we connect these connections very easily using this a little trace and VI strategy. Okay, so to make them connect, just I want to follow the same route, the upward. That route will be perfect for this connection. Okay, fine. Okay, so ground and 5 volt, I'm leaving that because at the end I'm going to create the polygon pore for ground and 5 volt. So that will automatically make them all connect. Okay. So that's why just, you know, we have to target the signal connection first. Okay. So now to make this connection, just select the layer 2. There is already a VI is placed, so just connect them with their VI. Okay, fine. And for this one, same rule, follow the same rule. So here I'm just going to around that pin number 2 to make this connection possible. So this is also a strategy. You can call it whatever you want. Just make it connect like that. Fine. So we have made this connection also. Now the first pin. Here we go. Just move it slightly little bit toward the right side. Fine. So I'm just going to follow the same strategy for this connection also. Just going around the 1, 2, 3, 4th pin. Perfect. Here we go. We have made all the connections with the J1. Just fit the board.